What does the classroom look like when educators and students adopt a culture of play and inquiry? Play experiences are co-developed. The classroom provides opportunities for collaboration, as well as opportunities for reflection. Students are practiced at resolving minor conflicts that sometimes occur in a cooperative environment. How can educators integrate play into their classroom, learn through the curriculum, and ensure that students acquire essential skills, including literacy and mathematics skills? What if your students are accustomed to a structured environment? Ease into play-based learning by gradually removing structure and constraints. Of course, removing structure doesn't mean removing teacher participation, but teacher involvement looks different along the continuum.
What if you use some of the other materials? Yeah, and there's this material too, that might be good.
In a structured, playful classroom, the educator chooses the area of study and develops a learning opportunity based on that theme. Although the educator has determined the topic, the students still have a say in deciding what to do.
That's a good idea.
The activity is hands-on and open-ended. There may be a question to answer or a challenge to solve. Each student is given the same challenge, but they have freedom to solve it in their own way. Many outcomes are possible, and students have opportunities for creativity.
Did you try to do the blowing test?
A structured, playful approach is similar to a guided inquiry. For more on guided inquiry, look for our inquiry video series.
You're thinking ahead.
As today's grade one class is studying the seasons, the class has been learning about how animals survive cold winters. Their challenge is to build a shelter for a toy animal. Students choose their own materials from a selection that Azadeh provides. A guided, playful approach uses a balance of structure and choice. The educator identifies a broad area of study, for example, a curriculum topic. They work with students to tease out their interests within that subject area. The educator develops the learning opportunities, but students have a say in what they do. The educator provides a variety of activities based on student interests. Students choose from among those provided, like diners at a buffet restaurant. Azadeh has developed a series of provocations for her students. After circle time, students are free to choose an activity and can switch stations at any time. Tables are set up with open-ended learning opportunities, with basic instructions or guided questions. Sometimes, students use materials in ways that are different from what Azadeh intended, or bring materials from one station to another. Azadeh is responsive to those innovations and actively engaged with her students as they learn.
Do you want to try making a bird or a fish? Yeah? There we go. Let's give you a little bit more space up here.
An open, playful approach gives students the most control over their experiences and their learning. In an open, playful approach, students choose their area of study and co-develop learning opportunities with their instructor. The educator provides a framework, but for the most part, students decide what to do. Azadeh and a colleague collaborate to provide their students with regular, unstructured time in nature. Each week, both classes spend an hour exploring an urban ravine near the school. The classes have prepared for the outing by working together to establish outdoor rules around safety and respect for living things. Students are free to explore in any way they wish. Educators sometimes observe, sometimes document, and sometimes enter student experiences as a play partner. Afterward, the classes debrief on their exploration, recording their impressions of the experience. The students' questions, theories, and wonderings determine how they follow up in the classroom. Some student contributions become long-term projects, conducted over the course of weeks or months. As a day in the class may co-develop play provocations for the classroom, based on the students' interests during the ravine exploration.
A little bit, but not very much.
If your class is accustomed to a more structured environment, a stepwise approach to play allows you to gradually increase student freedom and ensure that big ideas from the curriculum are integrated into your lessons. Opportunities for collaboration, reading, and journaling all support literacy. Up next, learn how to create a classroom environment for play.